301. Okay, you have some examples in the lab manual that I'd like for you to try. It's on my page 86 in the lab manual. That page number may change through the years, so just look in the table of contents in for quadratic applications. Right now it's in unit 2, and find these and then we'll go over them. Okay, so in the lab manual you have several to try, but there's a few things that we've thrown at you that you have to use a little critical thinking. The first, number one, notice that this is not in descending order, so you would want to rewrite this so that it's negative 4t squared plus 72t plus 55, so you don't get your a, b, and c wrong. The second thing, I'm just going to review one more time. If you read the problem, it says the value of Nathan's stock portfolio is given by this function, and it's in function notation. We understand all about that. V is the output. It's the value of the portfolio in hundreds of dollars, and T is time in months. So I would take time to write that down. T is time, this time in months. And the output V is in hundreds of dollars. Okay. And then you would draw your picture, just like I showed you. And it's still going to be an upside down U and all that. But I want you to understand something. I don't want to do this problem with you, but I do want to explain this. So let's say that I have an ordered pair in this problem, and it comes out to be, I don't know, 1, 2. How would you interpret that? Well, T is 1, and V is 2. But T is time in months, so that would stand for 1 month. What would that 2 stand for? V is money times 100. So when you're interpreting and you're pulling the number outside of the math, you have to multiply by 100. So that would be after 1 month, there's $200. Okay. You wouldn't put 200 into the problem. When you're working with the problem, you would put a 2. It's a way to make the number smaller. So that's how that works. The second one is straightforward. Okay, now take a look at this third one that is probably going to bother people because of the fractions. Well, this calculator that you're going to use is going to, it'll do fractions. A is negative 4/9, B is 24/9. Just use your calculator with the parentheses substitution method that I like to use, and you should be fine. You still want to draw a picture of the graph. It still opens upside down. So that one's just weird because of the fractions, but try to, you do the algebra, you let the calculator deal with the fractions. If you need to, just put parentheses around the fractions every time you type it in if you get scared. Okay, and then number four, wanted to look at, it says at the beginning of 1980 to 1990, the number of mountain bike owners, M is in millions, in the U.S. can be approximated by this model, and it's quadratic, but I want you to notice that it opens up this time. So we haven't done one like that. And then the other thing is that T equals 0 represents the beginning of 1980. Okay, so if we write down our Math English Dictionary, time T is years since 1980. And M is our output. That's the number of mountain bike owners, but it's in millions, times a million. So you're not going to put the whole million into the function, into the output. It's just going to be a smaller number. And you're not going to put the year, the actual year, into the function. So you have to understand what that means. So like this one, how many mountain bikers were there in 1980? 1980 is the real world year, but we want to use T equals 0 since 1980 is 0 years from 1980. If I wanted to know how many mountain bikers there were in 1990, then I would put 10 in. Okay, if I get a output of like 1.4, that means 1.4 million when you interpret it. All right, so if we sketch this graph, here's what the graph would look like. Instead of putting 1980 here and 1990 here, see, it's only working for these 10 years. I'm going to put 0 in that 10, and when it's time to interpret, I know that means 1980 and that means 1990. I know the y-intercept is the constant 3.96, but this is m in millions, so when it's time to interpret, that 3.96 really means 3.96 million, and I know it opens up. So this is what my function looks like. And so when I ask for the vertex, I'm going to be looking for a minimum, or vice versa. If I ask you for the minimum number of mountain bikers, you need to understand you're looking for the vertex.